Hey everybody, it's Tim Sackett, and you're back with another edition of Smash Ups, the video podcast brought to you by the great folks over at Fistful of Talent, so thank you to them. And then also, of course, thank you to our sponsor, Smashfly.com, the recruitment marketing platform that's out of this world. So make sure you check them out at Smashfly.com and thanking them for sponsoring. So I'm going to bring our guest in right away. It's Rob Kelly from OnGig. Rob, introduce us, tell us what OnGig's all about, and, give us some insight about you.
Sure. Appreciate that, Tim. Good to be here. OnGig's mission is to transform job descriptions, job ads. We use those interchangeably. And a little bit about myself, from New York City originally. I got turned on to business from my dad early on. He had the same mentor as Warren Buffett, as professor at Columbia University. So
nice mentor to have.
I kind of lucked out in that I grew up on Buffettisms and back when it would get you your butt kicked in school because Buffett wasn't nearly as cool as he's considered now. I don't know if cool is the right word, but rich might be the other word. And in fact, I just got invited to go out as one of 30 CEOs next year to the annual shareholders meeting. I'm totally fired up about that.
I'm a shareholder, so I get invited to go out every year too. Yeah, Nebraska Furniture Mart, we'll buy a couch together, you know.
So I've been real lucky. Just my dad didn't learn me English, that's for sure. My dad taught me to love business, and so I've always enjoyed business. I treat it like a game, and I've had some great jobs along the way. I got to write for some tech magazines. I've gotten to interview guys like Steve Jobs and Bill Gates. I worked for even a cooking software technology magazine once or article, and I got to meet Julia Childs. So I've just had a great time and went off and launched a couple different businesses, had some good fortune along the way, some great mentors, and that led me to OnGig, and this is what I'm doing the rest of my life as far as I'm concerned.
Well, cool. So I'm going to talk to you about the greatest thing you've ever written. probably not, but it might be the most trafficked thing you've ever written. So for those who don't know OnGig or don't know Rob, he writes, and I think it's done on a quarterly basis now.
Annual
basis. So
you want it quarterly, huh? Man, we're gonna have to get work.
How I consume stuff, I would take it quarterly.
So he's done going too slow for you, huh?
The top 75 ATSs, and it's on its third year so far.
Yep,
right?
Third year, yeah.
So third generation. I found it year one, wrote about it. Found it year two, and then wrote about it again in year three. So you started collecting this data. And the crazy thing is, when we do any of this stuff where it's top this, top that, list stuff, the HR thought leader, TA technology community kind of loses their minds because they'll go, oh, but they're not number one or they're not this. And one of the crazy things about your post on the top 75 ATSs is people want to talk about it. It gets a lot of play, but no one goes, they don't question it. They don't question the data. So one, why did you start this? Why did you decide, hey, we're just going to go out and do the top 75 ATSs? Why did you decide to do it? And then what's some learnings you've gotten from it?
Great question. You know, as you and I have talked about before, when I started off and started OnGig, I actually didn't know much about ATSs. And as I started to get into our mission of transforming job ads, you know, I found that the ATS is pretty important. It's what most employers use to generate it. Mm-hmm. And when I wanted to know who were the top ones, and I started searching market share of ATSs, and there was lots of comparisons of them on a software basis and some great articles. And we include all those resources because I think there's some great work there. But I couldn't find who's got the biggest pie, you know, slice. And that's me. I'm kind of an analytical guy. I like pie charts, and I want to know who's leading and who's growing the fastest. I was really curious about that.
Yep.
And so what we decided was, when we do this ourselves, we're talking to all these major hirers, these employers, and we're asking them which ATS they use. And let's just give it back to the community and see what happens. Now, it wasn't just purely out of the generosity of my heart. I also knew that it would bring attention to OnGig and have some potential clients.
It's content marketing at its finest, right? I mean,
you named it. You're good at that.
It's the one. Well, it's the one thing. Like I said, we've talked about this too. Is the one thing people ask me once I got into that HR TA tech space? They constantly want to talk to me about what ATS do you use? What ATS do you recommend? And I'm like, well, gosh, there's so many. It just depends on situations and size and, you know, your budget and everything else. So we're not talking about 100 data points. When you talk about measuring the ATS community, how many companies are you pulling in from that standpoint?
So we pull in, this year's was 99.
Mm-hmm. 99 ATSs, but ATSs. Out of, you have thousands of actual companies that are telling you what they how what they use, how they use, stuff like that.
Yeah. And we had over 3,000 employers who shared, you know, which ATS they're using. Importantly, though, these are 3,000 of the top ones. And we don't claim to have everyone in there, but we didn't just pick any Tom, Dick, and Harry. We said we're only out there talking to those who are hiring the most folks. But they include even startups because startups are hiring good amounts. And, you know, this covers a good 10 to 20% of the country based on our back of the envelope numbers. And are we off here 0.1 or 2% or, you know, it's directional. And if we are, you know, we encourage ATS guys to reach out and tell us that we're not doing it right. We get a lot of ATSs coming saying, include us in the report. Yeah. And I just say, tell us anything about your clients.
Yeah.
We'll go check. We're not running into you in the marketplace. So we share who we're running into. And in the first year, we only did the pie chart. And then we started adding the growth trend lines. And now we've got enough data where we can show by volume of hiring that you're doing, who's got the biggest pie chart, who's growing the most. And we're trying to help out employers to pick the right one for them.
So let's talk, give me the top three biggest ATSs and the top three growing ATSs.
Yep. Top three are Taleo, JobVite, and iSIMS. Now, there's a fourth in there, which is homegrown, meaning employers have built one themselves.
Yep.
So technically, that's the second largest market share. But
I know I joked in my post that if I had an ATS right now, I would change the entire branding to homegrown, and then piggyback your SEO, and I would become like the all of a sudden I'd be the fourth highest ATS being used in the world.
It's really funny because we got a lot of people saying like, "Tell us about the homegrown ATS." Like that sounds fun,
right?
You know, like homegrown and some guys out in a farm doing it or something. You know, it's smoking who knows what. But no, this was these are just people building their own internal systems, often going to an email, you know, a simple email apply.
Yep.
And by the way, some large companies still do that.
I know.
It's amazing, including we're always amazed. We get people overseas, like Fortune 500 companies who might have Taleo here, but then over in Malaysia, they to get Taleo for their team is too costly.
Yeah.
So in Malaysia, they do email only apply, and they have a little system.
We have a client, multi-billion dollar manufacturer in the U.S., and still does email apply.
Amazing. You asked about the fastest growing. So we do a few different measurements of fastest. We've got growth in market share, and there the top three are Greenhouse, Smart Recruiters, and Workday. Mm-hmm. Then we've got the fastest growing in terms of number of clients added. There's Workday, Cornerstone On Demand, and Lever, followed by Greenhouse fourth.
Well, and I think it's a good to point out when you take a look at like Workday and Cornerstone, Ultimate Software, some of those. There's a reason they're growing so fast, which is their HRSM, you know, human resource kind of core system is growing super fast, and a lot of companies are taking that on. And then the TA teams of those organizations are kind of getting this shoved down their throat a little bit, saying, hey, also, well, and there's a desire, I think, for some large companies to have one umbrella kind of full corporate end-to-end HR talent kind of platform in one, which Workday, Ultimate, Cornerstone kind of all fall in that kind of I wouldn't call them necessarily just an ATS because they're so much more than that, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. You nailed it. So those are some of the fastest growing ones. And then there's new guys. I mean, you know, we said a new ATS star on the rise. There's a bunch of smaller guys, but one of them is Google.
Yeah.
So, you know, Google is out there testing out their new ATS, and it's called Google Hire. And that's that is really fascinating.
Well, I think you were the first one to point out as well, when we take a look at CareerBuilder, which everyone considers a job board, CareerBuilder spent $1 billion developing TalentStream, which is a standalone ATS software, kind of a recruitment platform, which is really good. It's very dynamic. It's one of the better ones on the market right now. But yet nobody kind of looks at it that way. But you were the one that kind of point out like, hey, they already have like a pretty good foothold in the market on the enterprise side.
Yeah, they ranked number 14 overall, top ATS. So they're definitely making a dent. We see them all over the place.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting now that they've kind of got resold again from a private equity standpoint, how that might move forward if they break them up, job board, technology company, and kind of split them apart. I'm interested to see kind of how that plays out
How
from their
cool is it?
standpoint.
How cool is it that Monster and CareerBuilder now have gotten sold? I mean, it's gonna be a whole new guard on job boards. It's
No,
amazing.
like for me, like the crazier part too is like, they both got sold for right around half a billion dollars, right? And
Yep.
yet Slack is being rumored to be on the market for 9 billion, just a messaging platform versus, these companies that were thinking, wait a minute, like that, why would you spend 9 billion for that versus an entire, giant brand of Monster CareerBuilder or whatever it might be. So interesting from that standpoint for sure. So in the last 3 years, what are some of the trends you're seeing in the ATS market beyond just growth and percentages, but just overall from like just ATS technology? What are you seeing that's out there that's making an impact?
I mean, we just continue to be stunned by what's going on with ATSs. I just got off the phone with someone this morning talking about how they're moving from Taleo to Workday. Workday got them all sexed and psyched to make the migration. And then, at the very end, I think the guy said it was like, well, I'll give you his one-liner. It was really clever. But basically, at the end of the multiple meetings, when this head of talent acquisition went to his internal team and said, "Well, so when would we get our hands on Workday?" They said, "Well, the migration would take, probably will be done in 2019, middle of 2019." And this guy said, it just it, like, how is that going to help me today,
Yeah.
for acquiring talent?" And so I think that that's a really interesting dynamic is you have some of these, you mentioned, I mean, Workday is more than just an ATS, so it's got the whole suite. And when it affects other things, then suddenly that puts some handcuffs on the poor talent acquisition leaders who just need to attract new talent and track their candidates. And so these 2-3 year migrations over to big ATSs is I'm just fascinated by it. I think you can't innovate very well if you're doing that. Now, that's not all the ATS's fault. That could be internally some of the
Yeah,
clients
yeah.
move slow. But it shows how complex all this is. The other trend, we're really happy to see that some ATS's are doing open APIs, which means that you can customize these and you can get in there. And if you've got some software development expertise, so Greenhouse is really leading the way. They've said we're going to be open, totally
Yep.
open API, and they've built a community. And that, I believe, is the future of software in general, versus a closed off shop where we had one client come to us. It was a Taleo client, and they said, "Hey, Rob, can OnGig just help us take the About Us section of our job description and put it, change the text, and maybe even move it around in there?" And I said, "Wait, you can't do that already?" They said, "We have to do a statement of work just to get that sort of change." And I said, "Boy, that's again, you're moving slow." So I think,
Well, yeah, my big one has always been it's that one or two click apply, right? We know the more that we kind of create, again, when we were in the Great Recession, we had to put all these filters in and hoops for candidates to jump through, and it didn't matter because we were going to get people to come through anyways. But now we come out of that, we know over the next probably at least 5 years we're going to have this talent shortage, and so you can't have like. Taleo is a great example, and they're not the only one. The majority of ATSs still require you to register as a candidate to actually apply for a job. And
Yep.
people are like, well, yeah, that's but if a candidate really wants the job, they'll do that. I'm like, no, the best talent doesn't have to do that. And so why are you still doing this? And when I talk to the ATSs, they're like, well, TA leaders aren't asking us. They're not asking us for one click apply. They're fine with how we make them register for jobs. And I'm like, they're fine because they don't know that it's a possibility that they don't have to do that, right? That you can actually
Yep.
give them that ability. And then you start getting into Greenhouse and Lever and SmartRecruiters and some of these other ones that have figured that part of it out, and you don't have to do that, and you can just apply, without having to register. I think is one of those ones that we see too as a trend that the ATS world just has to figure out or it's going to go away.
Yeah, and so I think it's great. I mean, these big ATSs, Taleo, Workday, SuccessFactors, Connexa, I mean, these guys, they've got smart people on their team. They've got a lot of resources. And so I think it's great for the ATS market to have the new guys. You mentioned the greenhouses, levers, smart recruiters, and so forth, just pushing them hard. Competition's great. And by the way, I do, like you said, I do hear heads of TA saying, I want single apply, single click apply. So I don't know who you're talking to
The ATSs are telling me this, right? When I talk to heads of talent, they're saying the same thing. But then the ATS, like that, somehow that was not getting through to them. Or they're saying, well, it's not that important compared to all the other stuff we have to fix within our systems. I don't know. The one I hear recently is that they're like, well, we can't figure out how to get rid of dupes if we don't have registration, right? And I'm like, well, but all these other modern ATSs have figured this out. They don't worry about duplicate applicants. There's simple ways to figure that out downstream that you don't force the candidate to figure that out for you, you know?
Yep.
So it's one of those crazy pieces.
One other trend with ATS is that's interesting that affects what OnGig does with job descriptions, job ads, is we're seeing a lot of clients, more and more mergers and consolidations, spin-offs. And man, it gets dicey because you get, you know, a company like, one of our clients, WestRock, has got, they were formed out of Midwest Vaco and Rock 10. And one was using SuccessFactors. The other was using Connexa Brass Ring. They had to merge the candidate experience. And then they gobbled up another company with a different ATS. And then now they got some overseas, and for the candidate experience, they have to make this all work together so that when a candidate comes, as you were saying earlier, I mean, they just need to, enjoy the experience, have it simple application process. And they don't care about all these things. They don't want to, they don't know anything about ATSs, and they don't want to.
Yeah.
And it's just got to be, dead simple for them to engage and apply.
So last question, kind of a futuristic in nature, but if you were to take a look down the road 3-5 years from now, do you feel the ATS that we know and love and we use, love, I say that kind of tongue in cheek, but the ATS environment that we know right now, will it be the same way? And I say this going, I was at HireVue's conference a few weeks back and Josh Burson was there, and Josh goes, I think in 5 years, the ATS that we know of today will no longer be no longer designed, or it won't have the look of it of what we have today. So if you take a look at that, do you feel that an ATS market is beginning to shift, and that down the road, what we view as an ATS today won't even be close to what we view it as in 5 years?
Yeah, I do. I mean, if you think of, the Taleos and the Brass Rings of the world as being that first phase, first coming in, now you've got the new guard with Greenhouse and Lever and Smart Recruiters and some others coming in who are more open with APIs and more modern recruiting and software, as they call it. I think this third wave is going to have a lot to do with artificial intelligence and sort of anytime, anywhere, things knowing who you are. And, forget about clicks. I call it a one-click world. I mean, Amazon did this, right? They made it, they raised the bar. They said, you want to buy something, one-click ordering. And, I'm doing it all day. That's the only site I buy stuff from primarily.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to be the case with ATSs and candidates. And, the employers and the ATSs of the future are going to know all about those candidates. So you're not even going to have to worry about, filling out forms. It's all going to be there, whether it's on your LinkedIn already or in other ways. And the friction's going to go away. If you can remove all that friction between the candidate and the employer and get them chatting like they're hanging out at a bar together or barbecue, then that's what it's all about. And that's the beauty of technology. It does that. And so I think that's the third wave, which is why Google's ATS, Google Hire, is going to be really interesting, because if they match that with their Google for Jobs work, and we've looked real closely at their Google for Jobs API and are doing some work there, then suddenly you have AI combined. They might give away their ATS for free.
Could change the environment completely.
Last I heard, Google's pretty good with making money and cash on the back end. So, give that away and just bring the candidate and employer together. So that's why they're having a ripple effect here, Google's work. I mean, that's the big story. And whether it's Google or perhaps that just triggers this new wave, having to do with AI and location and a bunch of other things.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be a different world. I agree with Josh. 5 years from now, it's going to be a very, very different world.
Cool. So tell us how
picture goggles, man, you know, things that look cooler than this headset, but virtual, you know, reality headsets and putting them on. I mean, that stuff is for real. It's already going on. Hey, your guys, Michigan, man, University of Michigan, they're already doing it with their sports program with recruiting, which I know you know about. And new recruits come on and just put on the VR headset and they can picture what their job is. Score, score, score.
So tell everybody how they can get a hold of you, how they can find you.
Oh, real simple. You know, if any of this is interesting to you, the world of job descriptions, ATSs, you know, I'm just Rob Kelly on LinkedIn or rob@ongig.com or just visit ongig.com. There's a place you can click for a kind of strategic consulting meeting, and it's free, and we give away a lot of stuff. That's our spirit and philosophy, so that like-minded people come back to us. And I'm easy to find, and if you're like-minded, reach out and, you know, let's connect.
Cool. Once again, I want to thank Smashfly, our sponsor. Check them out at smashfly.com for recruitment marketing platform, which I'm sure in the future will be a part of whatever ATS kind of system we have. And maybe it's just going to be recruitment marketing platform. I don't know. And also,
I hope they pay extra for that, man. You're giving them good testimonial.
And also Fistful of Talent. Thanks to Chris and the gang over at Fistful for allowing us to do this. We'll check you guys out next time. Thanks for coming in and watching us.